Hey there, deep and wide thinker. I stumbled upon two fascinating ideas recently, each from wildly different worlds. One thinker is shaping the home education space, and while the other is innovating in visual creation. Now, what truly caught my attention was how these ideas unexpectedly converged. So I knew I had to explore this overlap and dive deeper. So in today's video, we're unpacking idea convergence, uncovering patterns and connecting ideas across time, and then how to cultivate thought forests from your notes. And this is all inside of the app Heptabase. So if you are interested in learning more about Heptabase and you want to know how to visually take notes, this video is going to be for you. I also have a link in the description below if you want to check out Heptabase. So the first idea is to engage, create, and learn every day, right? And Janice created this visual. He's a visual, he teaches people how to visually communicate ideas, and he's brilliant at it. Well, he created this visual of engage and create and learn, and then to do it every day, right? And so I stumbled across the idea. If I go into the info here, I wrote it down on July 26th. I can go to my journal and see exactly when I wrote this down, right? As a card that I wanted to think about. There's an idea that I was interested in. Okay, so I wrote that down. And now, a day later, I was reading through a book on home education. And I stumbled across this idea that, you know, as a parent, you want to have your child have something or someone to love, have something to do, and have something to think about every single day. Now, as I was thinking about this, and in two different days, I saw very similar ideas. And I thought, okay, there's something here. I need to kind of pause and think about these things. I want to walk you through step by step how I got from these two cards to the thought forest that we see right here. I got this idea of a thought forest from actually observing squirrels. I was standing under two massive trees, and I heard this rustling of leaves, right? And so I looked up to see a hurried squirrel crawling through the branches. And so I was curious, like, what is he going to do? So my eyes followed him as he was taking off from the last branch of the first tree, and then boom, he jumped about 2 feet in the air to the branch of the second tree. And that's when it hit me, right there. Like, this is a squirrel's playground. The squirrel can explore multiple trees without having to come back to the ground. And I thought, it's not so different with our notes, right? We can connect our notes together and hop from one note to the next to explore the land of ideas seamlessly. If you connect enough ideas, you create a thought forest. So that's what we're going to be looking at today, the thought forest. If you want to imagine, we have the relate tree, we have the create tree, and we have the learn tree. I want to pause just for a moment here and give you a free gift for hanging out with me today. This is a short PDF guide on how to get insights from the nonfiction books that you read and that you love into your PKM system. By the end of this guide, you'll have a simple system for highlighting your books, a mindful approach for adding content to your PKM system or PKM notes app, a process for creating building blocks of knowledge for the future, and then a simple tip for making more connections between your notes. The link to the free guide is in the description below. So the first thing that I did after creating the whiteboard was I created three text elements and named them relate, create, and learn. That's what you see here. All right, relate. This is simply a text element. When I right click, I can hit text, and it shows up as a text element. So that's what these are. All these arrows, or most of these arrows, a lot of these arrows are pointing to this word relate. And I can see in each of these, the metadata of the cards, that it's related or that it's connected to a text element, right? And some of these are connected to multiple text elements, which I'll get to that in a second. And then I went to my card library and began searching for ideas on these three areas. All right, so Command 3 opens up the right-hand side, and I started searching for ideas and dragging them onto the whiteboard. And then I started making connections from the cards to the words, to these words right here. So I drew a connection. If you hover over the card, you can see this draw connection icon. Or if you hit Command 2, you can hover over a card or any element, and it'll show up with those dots right here for you to draw a connection. And so I was drawing connections for all these cards to the words. All right, that was the first step. That was the foundation of the connection, right? All these cards related to the word. Then I started drawing connections between the ideas within those areas. One example is this quote right here by C.S. Lewis: all friendship comes from that moment when someone says, "What? You too? I thought I was the only one." All right? Now, I had this idea that I drew, or that I dragged onto the whiteboard, and then I had this idea, or this highlight from the book, The Power of Who. If you want to go and actually drag highlights, you can see Command 5 is the shortcut, or you can click the book icon, and it'll pull up all of your highlights from your Kindle imports and all that, from Readwise, actually, sorry. So I have multiple types of notes. I have these cards, the note cards, and then I have the highlights, right? If it's already in there, I went ahead and threw it on the whiteboard. Now, I know that this quote relates well with this quote. A friend is someone who knows the song in your heart and can sing it back to you when you've forgotten the words. So I went ahead and made the connection visually. And inside the card, you can see it's there as well. Something else that I saw was in the create tree. This here, this note. Art is what we call it when we create something new that changes someone. This is from Seth Godin, and this is from the book, The Practice, Shipping Creative Work. Now, I knew that this related really well with this experience that I have, and this is the note titled Boxes to Zombies. Surround yourself with people who can show you what's possible. This was a cool moment where my daughter was drawing little pictures inside of the app that I use to design inside of Figma. And so, you know, I was showing her around and how to draw boxes and all that stuff. And so she started drawing these little boxes, right? A box within a box within a box within a box. And she would make them different colors. And I said, what if we turn those into eyes? And so I started making this little dude, this little zombie, right? And it just kind of blew her mind. And I thought, that goes really well with art is what we call it when we create something new that changes someone. What I did, I was able to help Caitlin, my daughter, see what's possible. I was able to help her change, have a new perspective on what you can do. And then in the learn tree, this one right here, this idea, this quote, people don't have ideas. Ideas have people. All right, this goes really well with this idea right here. That's another quote from Charlotte Mason on home education. She says, give your child a single valuable idea and you've done more for his education than if you had laid upon his mind the burden of bushels of information. Right? This idea that I can provide a single valuable idea, and maybe every day that we provide ideas to our children, these valuable ideas, one of those ideas will already be something that, in this case, has that person, that has one of my kids, and they run with the idea, and they look further into the idea, and they learn about it, right? So these thoughts and these quotes go together really well, so I made the connection. And again, I can see that in the metadata here. And then as I was making connections, I actually had some moments where I was creating new ideas, right? For example, this quote from Jim Rohn: formal education will make you a living. Self-education will make you a fortune. And what I thought of when I read this, as I was inside of this context, is our income is tied to how we learn. Right? We can make more money when we dive into self-education and not just stop at formal education, but we actually learn how to grow continually. Our income is tied to how we learn. Another one of those moments is when I read this quote. This is on the Create Tree right here from Jeremy Riddle. There is a part of us that we will never unlock until we endeavor to create. Now, when I read that, I thought creating is an act that reveals who you are. It reveals another part of who you are. Creating is a part of how we are designed. And then I noticed some of these cards were actually overlapping and related to more than one area. Now this led me to more ideas and more connections. So far we've talked about how, you know, we've grouped these ideas and they're all related to these words in the middle here, right? And then we related the ideas to each other. And then we created new ideas based on what we saw and what we read and what we thought about. And then finally we have these overlapping ideas. This is where the thought force comes into play, where you see these huge lines drawn, right? And I can jump from the learn tree to the relate tree, and from the create tree, and from the create tree to the learn tree, and from the create tree to the relate tree. And so I want to give you some examples here. Let's go back to the quote, art is what we call it. Where is that at? It's in the create tree. Okay. Art is what we call it when we create something new that changes someone, right? Sharing our art involves others. It involves both relating and creating. Now, this inspired me to write kind of my own version, which is our creations can inspire change in someone. And a change for the good can spark a relationship. Right. In other words, we want to be around those people that help us become better versions of ourselves. Now, I made that connection here from reading this quote and thinking about how art, this quote, art is what we call it when we create something new that changes someone, is both created to this relate tree, this create tree, and also the relate tree. So in that context, I created this new note, which is now tied to this quote, okay? And it's tied to other quotes as well. Now, as I was thinking about this, I realized that I already created a note over here. Creating is an act that reveals who you are. But it also can inspire change in someone else. It can actually wake up something in somebody else and awaken purpose in somebody else. And it can awaken a hunger to learn and to grow and to know more by what you create, by what you make, which led me to a bridge idea of creating as a revealer and an affirmer of identity. When we create, we are revealing who we are, right? We're uncovering who we are, just a little piece every time that we create, but we're also affirming who somebody else is. Something else that I was thinking about as well. Give your child a single valuable idea and you have done more for his education than if you had laid upon his mind the burden of bushels of information. When I thought about that idea, as it relates to both learning and relating, because there's two people involved in this, right? There's a parent and there's a child. And the parent is the one who is providing the feast for the child, the feast of ideas for a child to chew on, right? And on the daily level, giving a child a single valuable idea to think about. And as I considered that, I drew a connection to this other idea. As a parent, you are not the source of the learning, but the facilitator of it. In home education, you don't need to know everything. And that's with life, right? You don't need to know all the answers as a parent, but you can be the facilitator of the learning. And I'd connected this thought to relate, the relate tree, and also the learn tree. Thank you so much for watching, for hanging out with me. I hope you enjoy these videos. If you have any questions on Heptabase, on visual note-taking, I'm all ears. Also, if you have any ideas on how you would build and create a thought forest inside of Heptabase, let me know. And I'll see you on the next video.